But Vantaa is a town,
new town, north of Helsinki.
It mainly consists of new suburbs built very quickly as big projects. Suburbs that are usually considered very down and lack identity. And there's also a problem with their location because they are deteriorating all the time. Many of our centers and working places are still unconscious. There are big buildings because they are built on private land, block by block. This is a problem, but it can be of course an asset also, because then you can accommodate new needs. You also get some kind of historical depth in the environment, in a new town without the history. The aesthetic quality of the environment or architecture is important as well for the well-being of the inhabitants, as for the success of the enterprises. And for this reason, architecture must be a part of the development strategy of any city. We made an architectural strategy in 2004 and 2005, and it was approved by the City Council. And this is important because it must not be just a statement about what we want. It must be also a kind of binding guidance, not only for architects and city planners, but for all the sectors of the city. And so we made a balanced scorecard because it's part of the city strategy. And the balanced scorecard is the way we do it. And it's not really a right and architectural style. The intention is to create good working conditions for creative work. And first you must know what you want, what your objectives are. Then you must know what kind of organization and processes you need to reach your objectives. And then you have to have certain knowledge and expertise to get it. And last but not least, you also need certain kind of resources to get what you want. But the first thing we need to strengthen is the identity of our town. Identity, of course, is what makes a residential area a hometown. And you can use, for example, a unique landscape in Finland of a certain area. Or you can use public art. But as important, residential areas are also other areas, workplace areas. The other thing that we want to create is a better quality of architecture. And by good architecture, we just don't mean just special buildings or structures, but the whole built environment, the whole man-made environment is what we need. Talk about architecture. To achieve these goals, we need the processes, and as you can see, we express our strategy in a kind of slogans that a city is recognized by its architecture, or city is our joint challenge, and so on, to make it understandable. And in fact, communication is one of the most important things that we do. We need a common vision. Not only the planners, but the decision makers, inhabitants, enterprises have to agree about certain goals. And for this reason, we, for example, organize exhibitions, or we give an annual prize for good architecture, try to put out a few meaning of architecture. See, these are results of many, many plans, not only urban plans, not only designs of buildings. And we have to coordinate all this planning in order to be able to create a good environment. And for this, we need cooperation, and we try to use internet and infographics especially. We also have to be sure that it's not just good intentions we have, but also the implementation of the planning is good. And we must also remember that the future of our cities already exists, a major part of it. We must take care of the existing environments as well. And then, of course, we need expertise and research. We, for example, have made an inventory and evaluation of our modern architecture from 1970s and 1980s to know what we have preserved to keep the historical depths. But the skills and creativity of planners and decision makers transform themselves into a better environment and into the best, better living conditions for the experts. And that's why I am here, in fact, to learn about the city center of Almere and maybe give you some information about a good practice in the field. Research, of course, is extremely important, and we have to know what our inhabitants want. And that's why we do an evaluation and a study on existing area every year to know how to develop better areas and how to improve that particular area. And then, of course, last but not least, we learn the resources. We need money and we need also human resources. And one very good way of getting human resources, get new ideas is to organize architectural competitions. We try to do as much as possible. And for the time being, we have an architectural competition about the new part of the town, which would be like north or foreign offices, for example, the Mecano architects from Delft are participating in this process. Sometimes decision makers consider planning too expensive, but in fact planning expenses are peanuts compared to the costs of building and maintenance. And we try to develop the public-private cooperation in this respect, and we also organize kind of planning competition for our private partners so that they have to do a certain thing to a certain price. And then we always must remember that the goal is really to improve the life of people. And sometimes there is a disconnect between the views of professional planners and the people who are used to the environment. But this thing we only can improve, I think, through a kind of conversation. The process of doing our architecture strategy was as important as the result of the resulting document. We organized, for example, 6 seminars about architecture for our decision makers and planners. But well, the bottom line anyway is very simple. Every intervention in the environment should be improved. Thank you.
Thank you very much.